divine powers are always working for us because we're doing right. You tuned in to the correct video because I'm about to tell you why you should not smoke weed, man. I'm going to tell you straight up in this video. Listen, for those of you out there who smoke weed right now, after this video, you might want to rethink smoking that joint, okay? But listen, I'm going to tell you some real shit, all right? I used to smoke weed. As a matter of fact, I probably had more weed than all of y'all put together, because I was friends with the person who sold weed. So every time I would get weed, I would always get my weed like in a big jar, like just like that. Then he had to pay for it. Scotch free. All right. I used to have plenty of weed, all different kinds of weed. Okay. But I'm going to tell you why you shouldn't smoke it. All right. Well, I'm going to say this. I think it was last year. Okay. I think I tried to smoke weed again like 3 times last year. The year before the last year is when I like stopped smoking. Okay. But last year, 2019, was when I tried to smoke again, like on and off. You know what I mean? I'll probably see my friends or whatever. They got a blunt lit up or something like that, and I'll just go take one puff of it. Okay. And I'm going to tell you what I experienced every time I went back to smoking, but I never really started back smoking. I just hit it one time, like every blue moon last year. Okay. Now, I used to smoke when I was younger. Like, I'm 31 years old, right? When I used to smoke, I was like in my early 20s, okay? I didn't have no focus in life, okay? I wasn't fully self-developed, you know? I wasn't conscious. I wasn't awakened, you know what I mean? I was just going through tough times, man. I was just going through tough times, you know? And the weed, for me, was like something that I could go to that would make me feel good. So-called make me feel good, you know? So I would roll up this high. I'm basically rolling up something to get me high so that I can leave from this earth plane. You know what I mean? That's looking back on it, that's what I was doing. You know what I mean? Every time some girls would come around, I would roll up some weed. You know, every time I would have a long conversation on the phone before somebody called, I got to roll up some weed. As soon as I wake up in the morning, it's like, I got to roll up some weed. You know, right before I go to sleep, I got to roll up some weed. Like, right before I watch a movie, why I got to roll up some weed? Like, and I just, like, over a course of time, I'm beginning to ask myself, I'm like, damn, I'm starting to be like a fiend or something. Like, why am I like searching for roaches in my car? Like, I started asking myself this, like, one day it just hit me. Like, one night I remember, like, I was in my car. I ain't have no more weed left. And I think my friend or whatever who was supplying me with the weed, they weren't nowhere to be found. And I was just kind of like fiending for it. Like, I was like, man, I gotta have a blunt. I gotta have an ill. Like, I gotta have it. I got to have it. So I'm looking around in my car like for something to smoke, because I knew I would always drop roaches in my car. So I'm just searching my car one day, like I'm cleaning it out and everything, like looking up under the seats, looking in the crevices of the seats, looking in the ashtray. I'm just like, yo, damn, I was going crazy in that moment because I could not find nothing to smoke. But I'm going to tell you when it hit me, like it hit me when I went back in the house and I sat down on the couch and I was just like, damn, man, I'm addicted to this shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know if you can admit it to yourself, but like I did to myself that day. I admitted to myself. I'm like, damn, man, I never thought I would be addicted to something. Like, damn, it's like, now I know what an addiction is. Like, you know what I mean? It's like something that you feel like you can't even live without. Like, you gotta have it. Like, and so that's what I was feeling like when I was looking for that roach. I'm like, damn, I'm a fiend for marijuana. Now, I know a lot of people might say, well, you're not no fiend, Trent, because marijuana come from the earth. But listen, my whole thing is this, man. It ain't nothing in this world that you should become addicted to the point that you literally start like tripping out, going crazy, getting mad, like feeling upset, getting depressed. Like, that's how you know you addicted to smoking, bro. Like, if when you don't get it, you're like, oh my God, like, I'm breaking down. My body is shutting down. I can't function without it. Like, you know what I mean? It's like, that's some addictive shit. You know what I mean? And so, you know, fast forward, man. Nowadays I don't smoke weed. But that moment kind of made me slow up a little bit. So I wouldn't necessarily buy weed like I normally would buy it after I had that experience. You know, and I did get some more weed after that day. You know what I mean? Everything was back to normal. But I slowed up a little bit. I was smoking like, you know, one blunt like every 2 or 3 days at that point, man, because I noticed, I had realized something about myself and I wanted to fix it, because I don't want to be no junkie. I don't want to be addicted to nothing. You know what I mean? Like, that's my mindset. I feel like I'm a strong mindset person. So it's like, I don't want to be addicted to nothing on this planet. You feel me? I don't want to be addicted to nothing. So, and the reason why I say that, because it gives you a sense of freedom. Like, you have freedom, you know what I mean? So, fast forward, here I am, 31 years old. It's been like a year and a half since I really smoked or whatever. And I'm gonna tell you, man, when I tried to go back to smoking, I'm gonna show you something that I noticed about smoking. This is why I'm telling you why you should not smoke weed. Okay, first of all, nowadays the weed that they smoking out there is not really 100% homegrown, 100% weed. It's not. I know that for a fact. It's not. It is not. This shit is synthetic. This shit is processed. Okay, y'all don't even know what y'all really smoking no more. It's not like it used to be. This is 2020. Y'all smoking that futuristic, robotical weed. You know what I mean? This shit got chemicals in it nowadays. I know that for a fact. And not unless you famous and rich, and you literally go to the crops where your man picking your weed out for you, and you see this with your own two eyes or something like that. But hey, it's only so many people that's out here that's rich like that and they got it like that. But if you ain't got it like that, I guarantee you, your weed is chemically processed. It got chemicals in it. And that's why I'm telling y'all, man, why you should not smoke it. You should not smoke the weed that they have out today, because the shit is designed to get you addicted. It's designed to get you addicted. The same way they put nicotine in cigarettes and they tell you what the long-term side effects is on the back of the box in bold print. Surgeon General warning, this shit, it will kill you, okay? But we just want you to smoke it because it has nicotine in it, and that nicotine will make you addicted to buying it. So you gotta have it. If you know that some people that smoke cigarettes, it's like a lot of weed people that smoke weed, why they gotta always smoke a cigarette after they smoke weed? Think about that. Because there's an addiction process going on. The stuff that they creating out here, the weed they got nowadays, they already know people gonna smoke it because they putting shit in it to make you come back for it. It's not 100% homegrown weed, all right? It's not 100% homegrown weed nowadays. And so another thing I experienced when I smoked that weed, I noticed, man, like, so I've been doing good. Like, I was doing good for a long time. I got my focus back. You know, weed used to make me lazy, more relaxed. I got my energy back. You know, I'm vitalized, I'm rejuvenated. But it's crazy because when I smoked that weed, like last year, the last time I smoked it, I hit it, I held it. You know, I noticed something, bro. Like, I noticed that it took away all the shit that I knew. It's like the veil was removed. It took away the veil that I had for myself. And it made me see the world as a dark place again. That's what the weed did. I'm like, yo, I see evil around me. I see demonic shit all around me. Like, but see, normally I'm always thinking in positive mindset. Normally I'm on a higher consciousness. But when I smoked that weed the last two times, it seemed like it just took away the veil off my eyes and showed me the dark world. I'm not lying. The weed nowadays, man, when you smoke weed, man, it shows you the dark world. It shows you all the problems about yourself. It literally, the weed that they make got so much chemicals in it, man, it talk to you. The damn weed be talking to you after you got high. You be talking to yourself in your brain. Like, it's really serious, man. So I noticed that about me. I'm like, damn, I'm not gonna smoke weed no more ever again. Because if I've came that far to the point that when I smoke weed, it makes me go back into negative thinking and negative mindset. I'm like, I'm not smoking it. I'm good. I got a natural high not even smoking. Okay, so, you know, that's what I did for myself, man. That's why I started smoking. Like, what I did, since I noticed that I was addicted to it, I noticed that I was like a weed fiend. Like, every day I had to roll up, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. When I noticed that and I stepped back a little bit, what I did was I said, I'm not going to be doing this shit forever, man. And I created a natural high system for myself. Like, I now do things that get me naturally high, man. I know exactly what I need to do to get me naturally high. By the way, if you want my formula on what I do to get naturally high that keeps me from smoking weed, you can purchase it from me. Just shoot me an email and say, Trent, I want to get naturally high. Okay, we can talk, chop it up or whatever. I'll give you my formula so you can get naturally high. All right. So, but anyway, that's what I did, man. I do it nowadays. I do it like the back of my hand. Like, I'm naturally high. Like, people see me, they see me so excited. They see me so energetic, so happy. People say, what's up, Trent? What you doing, man? Boy, you feeling good today, ain't you? You, boy, Trent, man, I like you, man. You always got energy, man. You always doing something positive, man. What's up? What you doing, Trent? I just be like, man, I'm naturally high, bro. Like, that's why I'm out here standing in front of these trees, because I don't smoke them no more. I just get a natural high when I'm out in, like, forest-type areas, like, where it's trees and greenery and stuff. I got a natural high. You can see it right now in this video. I got a natural high. I never smoked a blunt or nothing this morning. I don't even smoke anything. You know what I mean? And so, I'm saying that to say this, man, why you should not smoke weed, man. Listen, first and foremost, man, you shouldn't have to put anything into your body to make you feel good. You know what I mean? Alcohol. I drink now. I ain't gonna lie. I drink. But I'm not addicted to it. I don't wake up in the morning like, oh, I need a drink right now. I need a drink. I need to function. I need to get my mind back into function mode. So give me a drink. Like, no, I drink casually, you know what I mean? At events or with family or something like that. You know what I'm saying? And it's controlled. I know how to control it because I'm not fiending for it or nothing like that. You see what I'm saying? Like, but it's a problem, man, if you can't go a day without drinking. It's a problem if you can't go a day without smoking. That is a problem, whether you want to admit it or not. If you feel like you cannot go a day without smoking weed, bro, you have an addiction problem, whether you want to admit it or not, whether you say it comes from the earth. Listen, weed is different. Weed is like a hallucinogen. That shit, when you inhale it, it goes to your brain, okay? It goes to your brain, and it's also being held up also in your lungs, whether you want to believe it or not. And I know a lot of people smoke weed, but my question to you that smoke is, why do you feel like you have to have it? Why do you feel like you have to smoke something to make you feel good? Do you not naturally feel good? Are you not naturally intelligent? Why do you have to smoke weed to be more creative with your music? Think about it. If you're so genius and so intelligent and so smart, why is it that you have to internalize something that's external to put it into your body to make you function? That's some robotical shit. Like, basically, like, you got to get the batteries to make yourself work. Like, why? The human body is already powerful. The human mind is the most powerful tool in the whole entire universe. So it's like, why do you need anything to stimulate or enhance this shit that God has given us? The creator of the universe has given us a tool, a temple that is already well beyond what we can ever imagine of how great your body is. Why do you need something that's not 100% natural inside your body to make you feel relaxed or calm, cool, collective? Why is it that important that you have to have it, like an addiction? Do you find you scrambling for roaches everywhere? And another thing about weed, you know, looking back on it, man, another thing about it, you know what I'm saying, that I noticed about it, man, this shit I used to walk around, I used to have a stench on my body, a strong odor. So, like, I would spray a whole lot of cologne on my body before my mama came to visit me or something, or my daddy, because I mean, even though they knew I smoked weed, I just felt like it was more respectful to not smell like weed. So, weed got this stench to it, this odor. Like, if you roll down your window, for you weed smokers out there, you know, all the stuff that we dealing with in the world right now, as soon as you roll down your window, if you a heavy smoker and you smoke in the car, bro, they automatically gonna stereotype you because they smell weed. That's just another thing for them to have that they can use to get you out of the car, locked up in handcuffs. The police is already crooked nowadays. We already know that. So, I mean, that's all I say, man. Now I smell good, man. Now I be walking around smelling like Bond number 9, smelling like Porsche InDesign, smelling like Bora Bora. Avengers, Creed. I be smelling great nowadays, you know what I'm saying? And that's because I ain't got no stench on me. I don't walk around with no weed odor. That shit it's a terrible smell, bro. I mean, it's a terrible smell for people who don't smoke. Think about it. I mean, I know the smokers like it. Oh, I'm walking around with that weed odor. I'm walking around with that weed odor. But okay, only the smokers like that odor. But when you go around like public events and shit like that, and you trying to be fly, fresh, you trying to smell good, crispy, and clean, that shit stinks, man. It stinks, bro. And like I said, I know a lot of my friends out there smoking. I ain't got nothing against them or nothing. They know they smoke. And then they tell you, Trent, don't smoke. They know I don't smoke. But it's like when you get in a car, that shit just got a heavy, strong odor on it. The shit is in their fabric, in their seats. Like, come on, man. Come on, man. You can wake up without having to smoke weed. I did. I'm awake right now. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. This is Trenton Sanderson. I'm awake. I'm a star seed living in a star seed world. Damn, Trent hot right now. Somebody please turn on the AC. It's hot out here today. So I'm just telling you why you should not smoke weed, man. That's why, man. It ain't even like it used to be no more. It's, shit is dumbed down. The weed is dumbed down nowadays. You ain't getting high off no 100% homegrown weed. You don't even know where it came from. You just bought it from somebody. They don't even know where it came from. They just got it from somebody. This shit been passed down. By the time it get to you, this shit is a chemical. You inhaling chemicals. Do your research, man. Stay woke, man. I'm Trenton Sanderson. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hey, share this video to one of your friends and see what they think. They'll tell you what I'm saying is the truth. Trust and believe it. Star seed. I'll see you in my next video. Oh, yeah, make sure you subscribe up there too by clicking my face icon. Hit that bell notification so you can be notified every time Trent upload new videos every single day. Peace.